In this tutorial, we will see how to use this metadata properties in Talent. If you look at this metadata properties, you know, you see here, if you expand here, there are many options to provide metadata. So in my case, I am reading a delimited file using T file input delimited step. So here, when you are trying to insert, you know, schema, if you create it is time taking process, because for one job you can edit, not for multiple jobs. So in this case, rather than using built-in, there will be two options. One is built-in, another one is a repository. So built-in means every time you need to edit schema, means you have to provide, because earlier it was there. So basically it will come with, you know, empty notation. When you browse this file and provide delimiter, basically it will be empty and how to edit it manually. So there is another option, we can store that metadata here in this section, metadata section, and select this schema as a repository, and you can propagate it. Yes, yeah, you can browse this file delimited, product delimited, metadata. Once you select this, and if you see edit schema, columns will be available. So it is like time saving for you while designing the job. So to create this, you just give a right click here on file delimited and create file delimited. Give some naming convention for this. Click on next. So let me give delimiter that is available in my file, and also header is presented over here. So refresh preview. This is just to ensure about your data preview. Click on next. Yeah, here provide naming convention. Product. Let me see. Product underscore AAA. Here there is a test metadata is available. Okay. Test metadata. Two columns, product AAA and status AAA. Now you see here, I will browse that file delimited, test metadata, metadata. Click OK. Yes. And you see here, edit schema, view schema. So product AAA. This is how you can import metadata to your job. So this is time saving process if you are working with multiple files. So similarly, context variable, there is one more section available here, context. Yeah, here also it is like a parameter substitution to your job. So for creating a context group, right click here, create context group, and provide here itself you will add multiple parameters, that's what context variables. And once you use this context variables, you know, you can provide values also. Just click on finish, and when you are importing to your job, what you need to do, you select this context section, and there is an option here to import those particular context variables to your work location. So when you click here, select test name. So all those context variables will be available to you see new 1, new 2, new 3, and then you can start using them in your job. So wherever you want, you can specify here. If you see here, context dot space control space, so all these context variables are available. So this is it for session. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe.